outputs and the positive sense, and we can help people turn on, tune in, turn on.
Yeah,
you know,
I mean, we live,
everybody can do it.
Yeah, we live in a world where it's possible, and it's not only possible, it's doable. You know, it's just, you know, you have to just, certain things people have never heard even or thought of, and sometimes when they start thinking of these things, all of a sudden, click, their mind comes on, they start, you know, seeing spirits, or they start talking about, you know, metaphysical, or what, maybe just odd experiences happen to
like Alex.
Yeah.
Like, you've seen the video with our friend Alex, like, he's all still real pumped up about this. One day his mind just went.
Yeah, it was like one day out of the blue. And see, I've known Alex for 4 years now, and one day, out of nowhere, he just starts telling me, you know, the spirit's coming through, the Buddha's coming through, all he could talk about all day long. And of course, my mom was skeptical to see where he was going with it, so I just didn't say much about it, but he's seeing the same thing I'm seeing, you know.
And me too.
Yeah, and it's like, wow, man, you know, you just clicked on. So anybody and everybody's capable of this. You know, it's where you let yourself go and understanding what you might feel is fantasy sometimes, too.
It's not fantasy. Trust me. Fantasy is a lot more than fantasy. Fantasy is reality. This is something I told one of our friends yesterday, or one of our friends, clients, whatever you could call it. Some of the people who ask for help, I don't want to say client, sounds like a law firm or something. You know, I tell our friends, our brother, one of our, I guess our brothers and sisters that call for help, that's the way to go. We're all brothers and sisters. But one of our brothers that called from the West Coast with some questions mentioned that, you know, something about that, you know, like turning on his mind and stuff, and you know that about doing that, and you know.
Oh, we would love it if you know, like that people would just kind of open up like wildfire.
That's what we're trying to do. Yeah. We're trying to create spiritual teachers. Like, we try to tune into people and turn them on.
We're not trying to be the top dogs. We're just
trying to create more.
Yeah, like a, you know, not like
fire.
Yeah, like a wildfire.
And the world needs lots of spiritual teachers like that. We need a lot. Everyone needs. We're turning on as many people as we can, and hopefully maybe we've inspired some of you watching this to go ahead and go with your soul and heart and soul on what you feel you're really meant to do, and do it without fear. Step beyond this crazy-ass world.
Yeah.
And deal and do what you feel is right. If you have spiritual things you need to teach people, say them to people. You know, just mention them, you know, without judging people. Just, you know, talk to them.
One of the best ways I can help, you know, and I said this to many people, is, you know, and friends, family, and everybody, is to pay attention to your karma. Now, when you do something good, expect something good back. But when you do something bad, expect something good back.
But don't expect it. Don't do things, perform actions like that, expecting it. Just doing it for that reason, because you want something back. It's got to come from the heart and soul, AI.
Yeah, because
you could know something will come back, but don't be like, well, I'm doing this just because I want something back.
Well, that's what I was getting to.
Without concern for reward, form action.
Because you never know when it's going to come back to you, and you never know what form is going to come back to you. I would just say recognize, because you if you do good, you do good, and you know, you can. That's the answer. You're doing good, expect good things to happen. Not tomorrow, maybe not the next day, maybe not the same thing as you're doing, you know, but also when that next good thing happens to you, go, hey, maybe it's because I did something good.
That's right.
But also, when you do that bad thing,
you know it's going to be bad.
Yeah,
it's coming.
When that bad thing happens to you, don't be mad at the world.
Don't be mad at anything.
Yeah.
Just be like, okay, this is what it's meant to be. Just be happy about it.
Yeah.
Yes, you can accept it.
You know,
that way you can get rid of it.
Yeah.
And move on.
It just comes. It's going to happen. It's part of your life cycle.
Me and Jeremy get fast return on bad karma. I found that to be true. Like, it's meant for us to clear it out of our systems and by energies quick. You know, some people in their lifetimes, they put it off. They'll do things, real bad things, and then they'll be putting it off till later in that life or their next physical lifetime or the next one after that.
Right.
You can't put it off forever. One day it will happen. It might be 1,000 years later. Of lifetimes, but it's going to be back. So
yeah, someday when you just have
ours comes back instantly. It doesn't take, but sometimes it happens like within minutes.
Yeah, when you're having a bad day sometimes
we unintentionally do things and well, not like, much anymore.
Like when you're having those bad days and things like that, just remember, you know, this too shall pass. It may be because of this, that. It's you know, it's part of your life cycle, you know. The good things too. So don't trip out so much on the bad and the good. Try to be more accepting
of all of it.
All of it, yeah.
That's what we do, and we learn that's a key to the spiritual understanding, even spiritual mastery. It's one of the most important things, is that acceptance. You know, you start out accepting every little thing, you know, no matter what, happily accepting what comes to you in your life. And then once you start doing that, yeah, that's how the way you open the door to change. Once you accept everything that you've got now, then you can change it. Then that you can open the door, and then you can work and get what you really prefer and desire. And your dreams can come true after that.
And even if you, you really, really want, you know, like, you can create your own reality, so.
And you are right now, even if you don't know it, you are.
Sometimes you can want something so bad, or something to happen so bad, you know.
And then it doesn't happen.
Yeah, but sometimes it does.
But the thing is that if you want it, you're saying that you want the experience of wanting. You got to be careful with that. It's that I want to be wealthy. And then you never get wealthy, but actually your dream has come true. It's supposed to what you really want because of your thoughts, because you're saying you want to experience wanting to be wealthy.
Yeah.
Not being wealthy, but the sitting there wanting.
Right.
Yeah, that's literally, the words come true, literally.
Yeah.
So you say, I will become wealthy within this amount of time and believe it. I am wealthy now. That's a good way. And believe it, then it can come true.
Yeah, cause I don't think wealth is always about money either.
It's about a lot of other things.
Yeah, lots of things, yeah.
I just wanted to say, too, we answered this kind of another question was answered by this, too. Can anybody be psychic, or does it take a special person? Like, that's, we kind of answered that, too, I think, in there. It applies to psychic things, too, as well as seeing spirits.
Yeah.
You know, anybody could, especially, it may be even a little easier to use your intuition first and then move into seeing spirits. It depends. You know, you could start with that. It might be a little easier to do that. It's anybody can use your intuition. Now, everybody's psychic. Let me say that. And you don't have to call that Miss Cleo girl and all that shit. You know, I remember that Miss Cleo thing. That shit was great. Yeah, all that fake shit. You don't have to pay somebody $1,000 an hour.
Oh, I see it all the time on TV. No offense to anybody, but it was like psychic friends and stuff.
You
call a building probably full of like hundreds of people just answering the phone, just
making up stuff,
you know, making you pay money to hear, you know.
$10 a minute sometimes, you know.
I know it racks up, because when I was a kid, I called a psychic thing, and it just...
We got 2 minutes.
Yeah, it just blew up money, you know, that's all it did, and I don't think any of the advice was good, you know, oh yes, you will find somebody in the future. Stuff like that. You will find somebody. But if I, you know, kind of like, yeah, I guess I will find somebody.
Psychically, we use our dispersed impressions. That's what you need to do. Like when you're like answering, trying to think of an answer, you don't think, try to think of it. You just see what pops in your mind. You know, like without like, sometimes like you'd be asking the question before you even finish asking it, there's an answer. And when it comes like that, trust that answer. Let me say that, because you got the right answer.
Yeah, not too many psychics are going to tell you about the bad things that are going on.
Yeah, we don't hold back. We'll say if we see something negative.
Yeah, we'll try to tell the truth, but we'll be back.
All right. Be right back. Peace.